¿Venimos?
Hello and welcome back everybody here for Polo Line TV. Guys, we're here at Zakara to present today the game in between Skåne and Monterosso Vikings for the Prince of Wales Trophy held by the Royal Berkshire Polo Club. As we know, we're getting into the sixth game. Today is 22 degrees, the rain is 20%. The field, as I told you before, is Zakara, and the teams today are Skåne versus Monterosso Vikings. So before we start this game, guys, I'm going to show you some highlights of the games before, the games yesterday. Hope you enjoy, and we will be back with you shortly to the beginning of this game that we're looking forward to start in a couple of minutes. Facundo Pérez coming behind to protect. Patrick has to move away from Borodin. Gonzalite Facundo Pérez with an action looking for Kian Hall. Kian Hall with a little flick under the shot. Let's see, under the next shot, a little back shot. It's a goal. Gonzalito Pérez, he's trying to extend the team of the defending team to put Gonzalito further backwards, but Gonzalito picked up the ball and he's coming all the way back through the middle of the field. Jaime keeps chasing, trying to see if he can ride him off. Gonzalito fast. He's going fast, kicking. Going past the 60 yards, Gonzalito, all alone, Gonzalito, half swing, he only have one tap left, beautiful approach from Gonzalito, golazo, he ends up coming in, tapping the ball in the air, Kian Hall that turn it, Kian Hall again with the ball, now Facundo trying to pick up the loose ball and Jaime couldn't get it, and then Facundo with the next shot, and it's a goal. It's the end of the game, the final score is 6-3 in favor of Park Place. Okay, guys, hope you enjoyed those highlights from yesterday. We're here, like I said before, to present you what is going to be the game in between Skåne and Monterosso Vikings. The umpires for today are Peter Wright and Jason Dixon, and the third man will be Tim Bound. Soon I will be showing you the teams for each side. We go first with Skåne. Number one in Skåne is Will Druid, 0 goals of handicap. Number two is Oli Cadmore, 6 goals of handicap. Number three is Nicolas Pierres with 9 goals of handicap. And number four is James Harper with 7 goals of handicap. The handicap for this team is 22 goals. As we saw there, it says 0-1. That means that the first game they have lost. And they have this is going to be their next game. So let's see how they're going to do today. In the other side, we have Siri Bassoni, number one, with 0 goals of handicap. Fran Elizalde with 8 goals of handicap, number two. George Marek, number three, with 6 goals of handicap. 6 goals of handicap. And Sebastián Merlo with 8 goals of handicap. Total of the team, 22 goals of handicap. The games, as before, they lost their first game. So here we are. This is for them. Whoever wins will have the chance to go into penalty shootout, depending the leagues tomorrow. But we're expecting a really good game in between two very competitive teams. As we said this today before, the weather is quite nice. It's fresh. Perfect situation for the horses. The pitch looks in immaculate condition here at Zakara. And we're waiting for the umpires to decide which team is going which way. Obviously, they're going to flick a coin, as we've been doing for the rest of the tournament. They flick a coin, they're going to decide size. I think that the winner of the toss is Skåne. And we'll see. The winner was Monterosso, I think, that is going to get the possession of the ball starting from the 60 yards. In the meantime, I'm going to give you the ways that you guys can follow us, which is through Instagram in @PoloLineOK, through Facebook @PoloLineInt, and in Twitter @PoloLine. okay? So we're expecting a really good game for today, guys, and we're going to see. Now, Monterosso Vikings starting from the back, from the 60-yard line. I think the man in charge of the ball today is going to be Sebastián Merlos. And here we go. The game is about to start with Sebastián Merlos, with the ball. Sebastián, Oli Katmur, that stay with Sebastián. Sebastián trying to get the foul of Oli Katmur. Oli Katmur goes for the ball. He gets the hook. Sebastián Merlos with the ball. He leaves the ball for Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde comes in behind. Fran Elizalde leaves the ball for Sebi Merlos. Sebi Merlos passes the ball to Fran Elizalde again. Fran Elizalde being chased by James Harper. Fran Elizalde, he goes all along with the ball. He hits from there, try to get across, un approach to goal. The first one on the ball is Nicolás Pieres. Nico Pieres with an open back shot looking for Oli Katmur. Oli Katmur, he gets the upper hand with Sebi Merlos. Fran Elizalde that walks over his line. They give advantage. The ball gets him behind for James Harper. James Harper with the ball. James Harper is coming across the middle of the field. James Harper, he takes the ball with him. The ball being stolen by Sebi Merlos. Sebi Merlos with the ball. Now the ball is recovered by who? Sebi Merlos. Sebi Merlos. No, sorry, that's George Marek. George Marek with the ball. George Marek has to go past Nico Pieres. George Marek with the position of the ball. George Marek, he passed the ball to Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde that turns one way. He comes the other way. He gets away from the lot. And now once he has a little bit of space, he's going to hit the ball to goal. There we go. He hits the ball strong to goal from there. Fantastic shot from Fran Elizalde to break the even score and put the first goal in favor of Monterosso Vikings. From 80 yards, he saw the goal. He went away from the lot. He had a chance to hit. And as soon as he could, he hit. The ball went straight through the middle of the goal. Fantastic goal for Francisco Elizalde. Here we go. James Harper to restart this game from the 60 yards. James looking for Nico Pieres. Nico Pieres waiting for the ball. The ball intercepted there by Fran Elizalde. I think the umpires have blown. I think that it wasn't enough of a gap. Fran Elizalde had a good idea. The gap wasn't just big enough, so the umpires decided to give a penalty, and it's going to be from the 5B in favor of Skon. Sorry, they taking it up to penalty 4. They obviously thought that a 5B wasn't... They obviously thought that it wasn't that much of a gift to give a 5B since they were quite close. So they probably, that's why the idea today with the new rules is trying to move forward to encourage people to foul as less as possible. So the punishment is a bit more severe. So now the umpires drop the ball in the 60 yards and the man in charge is Nicolás Pieres. Nico Pieres with the ball. 60 yards penalty. Nico Pieres. He hits the ball long, strong, high. And it's a goal. Fantastic goal from Nico Pieres to make this game 1-1 in the first checker. 5 minutes 37. Very evenly matched so far. Nice and quiet for everybody. And now we are waiting for the umpire to count till 20 seconds. And he will drop the ball on the 60 yards. George Marek that goes for the pass. Fran Elizalde goes for the pass. And Sebi Merlos with the ball. Sebi Merlos. He looks from Fran Elizalde on the right. Fran Elizalde has to go past Nico Pieres. He tries his best. Nico Pieres keep chasing. Fran Elizalde with the ball in the near side. Fran Elizalde. He taps it to the left. Fran Elizalde. He gets the ball. Nico Pieres with the bump. Trying to get the ball of him. Fran Elizalde, beautiful play by Fran. He passed the ball back to George Marek. George Marek on the near side. No, he takes it to the right. Fran Elizalde. Ay, ay, ay. It was a good play from Will Druitz trying to get that ball. Apparently, he got into a little bit of the line of George Marek. That nicely, he plays that well on the inside. So the umpires decide to blow the whistle. And it's going to be a penalty from the 30 or 40 yards. Let's see what the umpires decide. The replay, it was there. Now I think it's going to be from the 30 yards in favor of Monterosso Vikings. It looks to me like it's a 30 yards. The players are all in behind the goal. Looks like a close distance. The man in charge of the penalty is going to be Sebastián Merlos. He He's gone for a little walk. He's going to approach this walk at a walk. Sebastián Merlos. Nice and easy shot for Sebastián, and he scored what is the second goal in favor of Monterosso Viking. The score 2-1. Time 4 minutes 40 seconds of this first checker. Now, who is it? James Harper to bring the ball from the back for Scone. Let's see what he does. In the play before, he looks for Nico Pérez. Let's see now. The first one there to mark is Sebi Merlos with Harper. The ball goes here for Nico Pérez. Fran Elizalde is quick with Nico. And now the ball. Sorry, Sebi Merlos here now. He's been asked for a backhander. The backhander goes there for Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde with the possession of the ball. Fran Elizalde stays with it. Fran Elizalde, what a play from Fran Elizalde. Very strong play, Fran Elizalde. He goes all away with himself. Being chased by Will Druid. Will Druid that took the ball. Will Druid that leaves the ball. Ah, he left the ball. Harper that hits the horse of Will, but the ball gets picked up by Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez can get hold of it. He left it for Oli Cadmore. Oli Cadmore with possession of the ball. Oli Cadmore. He's going to pass it back to Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez all alone, trying to take the ball with him. Nico Pérez, he picks up the bouncing ball. Nico Pérez with the ball, he's coming in. Sebastián Merlos, being pushed in the line by Will Druid. He backed it to Fran Elizalde. And now there is no advantage. The umpire blows the whistle. Here we go. Let's see what the umpires decide after this free change. The replay is there. Fran Elizalde takes the ball. I think he taps it once. I think that James Harper has to come out. And he takes the ball with him. I think he should have given one shot more to Fran Elizalde. So by the looks of it, it's going to be a penalty in favor of Monterosso Vikings. As we all know, the umpires are giving a free change for everybody to change the fresh ponies. So that's why we're changing in the middle of the checkers. This is a warm-up tournament, so the horses are not completely fit. That's why we're trying to go with the horses more than normal. So if we have the chance to stop, they will, and they give the horses a chance to be changed and the players the chance to come back with fresh ponies. We're waiting for the players to come back. The umpires drop the ball on the ground. We're waiting for Siri Bassoni. He's coming on that beautiful chestnut mare. Here we go. The foul is from the spot in favor of Monterosso Viking. Sebastián Merlo with the ball. Sebastián is going to look for Fran Elizalde for sure. Here we go. The pass for Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde is quick. Go past James Harper. He takes the ball. He checks. He will pass the ball. Leaves the ball for George Marek. The ball got left there for Marek. Marek with Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez has to move from the way. He leaves the ball for Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde with the ball. He goes past Nico Pérez. Fran Elizalde, he's on fire today. Fran Elizalde is going past everybody. That's one of his days for Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde with a little tap and he scores what is to be the third goal in favor of Monterosso Viking. 3-1 on the favor. Fran Elizalde is unstoppable today with two goals of Fran. The first one from a very long way. The second one now with a beautiful play, picking up the ball from George Marek and taking it all the way. Being chased by Nico Pérez, that not much he could have done because Fran today is unstoppable. Here we go again. Fran, James Harper. James Harper. Marek, that goes to Harper. Fran Elizalde again on the ball. Fran Elizalde takes the ball for Monterosso Vikings. It's going to turn with it. One way, the other one. He's in one of those days, let me tell you. Fran Elizalde in one of those days could be the most annoying thing that could happen to any player in the world. And here we go. The pass goes for Siri Bassoni. Siri Bassoni goes high. She goes. There she goes. She goes. One tap. The other tap. The second tap. The ball goes left there for Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez that taps it sideways. Nico Pérez that takes the ball with him. Nico Pérez is coming across the middle of the field. Nico Pérez. He checks. He's waiting for Harper to go for the pass. James Harper that goes for the pass. The ball is there for Will Druid. Will Druid on the near side. The backhander of Josh Marrick. Looking for Fran Elizalde. He cannot get it. Nico Pérez get the ball. Nico Pérez with the ball. Nico Pérez taps it once. Taps it twice. Nico Pérez. And there's a whistle. Let's see what the umpires decide. The umpires decide that Nico Pérez shouldn't have given that much of a follow through to that swing because Sebi was on the inside, which it could be a little bit dangerous. So they call it a penalty from the spot in favor of Monterosso Viking. With the ball, Sebastián Merlo. Again, looking for Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde, a little bit long the pass this time for Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez, he tried to pick the bouncing ball and it's James Harper that pick up the loose ball. Fran Elizalde, Harper makes James go pass and then he goes for the hook. Nico Pérez goes left with the ball. Good play from James Harper. Now Nico Pérez hit the ball far and long, puts the ball in the 30 yards. A little bit on the side. Let's see who's the first one in there. The first one was George Marrick with a little bit of a backhand. And now the ball left far. Sebi Merlo, Sebi Merlo tried to get rid of that ball. Looking for, who's there? Marrick. On the ball with Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez. I think it was Fran Elizalde. That again, similar play to the one before. He had a player on the inside riding him off and he goes for the next shot. As we see there, when it's not much left to do because the boards are there, so the only way to get rid of the ball is to push. If you see how the stick follows through and almost end up hitting the horse of Nico, that's why the penalty is for. The umpires don't like that, so they blow from the spot in favor of Scone. With the ball, Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez from there to the goal. Beautiful shot from Nico Pérez. We've seen him score before from there, so anything could happen when the ball is in the stick of Nico Pérez. The ball went just wide, and it's going to be Kings. Of this first checker. As we know, with these new rules, they're going to play for the next 30 seconds. They have to. So let's see what they can do with 30 seconds on the clock. It's only 15 left now. Will Druis with the backhand. The ball for Harper. Harper with the next shot. He can get the hold of the ball the way he wanted. And Nico Pérez, again, Josh Marrick with the ball. And here we go. The second bell is gone. And guys, thank you very much. This is the first checker just finished. The score is 3-1 in favor of Monterosso Vikings. And we will be back shortly for the second checker. Welcome back, everybody. We're here waiting for the players to come back on the field for the beginning of this second checker. For those ones that just tune in, we are playing the Prince of Wales Trophy held by the Royal County Berkshire Polo Club. The game today is between Scone and Monterosso Vikings, and the score is 3-1 in favor of Monterosso Vikings. I will quickly go through the players again for you guys to know who you're playing. On the red team for Scone, Will Druid in number one. In number two with the... With the gray helmet is Nicolás Pérez. Number three is Oli Cadmour. In number four is James Harper. And for Monterosso Viking, we have number one, Siri Bassoni. Number two, George Marek. Number three, Fran Elizalde. Number four, Sebastián Merlo. The umpires for today are Tim Bound and Jason, and Peter Wright. And the third man is Jason Dixon. So we're ready to go. James Harper with the ball for Scone. James Harper looking for Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez being chased by Fran Elizalde. Good job from Oli Cadmour to get rid of Fran. Nico Pérez hits the ball looking for the pass for one of his teammates. The first one there is Siri Bassoni. Siri Bassoni that tried to take the ball on the front forward to award the boards. The ball got left there in behind, but there's a whistle. There's a whistle. I think that the umpires blow that James Harper checked a little bit too much on that line. Let's see what they decide, but the replay is showing us that the ball got left there. And who's there? Will that tries to go on the near side. The ball got left there for George Marek. And then there, when James Harper tried to check to get the possession of the ball, is Sebastián Merlos coming along that line. The umpires weren't happy with that, so they blow a penalty from the spot in favor of Monterosso Viking that is already on the play with the ball, Francisco Elizalde. Now, Harper is the one that steals that ball on the near side. Fran goes. He gets for the hook. Fran Elizalde, he steals the ball of Nico Pérez and James Harper, both of them. And now Nico Pérez recovered the ball, but Fran Elizalde picks up the loose ball. Fran Elizalde tried to get hold of it. He gives it back to Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez with the ball. He tries to tap it in. Nico Pérez cannot get hold of it. The hook is a good one from Peter Sebastián Merlo that he turns. And he was quick on the line. Will Druid to appeal for that line. The umpires blow the turning on Sebi Merlos. And it's a penalty. It's going to be in favor of Scone. Let's see what the umpires decide. But for me, from there, let's see. I think it's going to be a penalty four. Penalty four, probably because they didn't have possession. The possession was on the number four of the white team. So that's why they don't go that much further up the field. If he would have had the position of the field, the off the ball, probably would have been up to penalty three. But it's not. So, from the 60 yards, Nicolás Pérez. Nico Pérez, and the ball goes a little bit wide. Over the back line will be Sebastián Merlos. Sebi Merlos with the ball. Sebi Merlos looking for Fran Elizalde on the grey horse. James Harper comes to cut him down. Fran Elizalde cannot get the ball. George Marek. Nothing that Harper can do. He has to get off the way. Harper ends up kicking the horse the ball, so it gives him the upper hand, and he ends up with the ball. James Harper with the ball. Sebi Merlos. He tried forward, he tried backwards. He ends up taking the ball on the backhand. And now Nico Pérez. It won't surprise me. He hits from there to goal. Nico Pérez. There he goes with a shot and a bit wide. It's putting pressure, Scone, on the score, on the goal of Monterosso Vikings. So here we go. Fran Elizalde with the ball for Sebastián Merlos. Somehow they have changed the way of the knock-ins. It went from Sebi Merlo to Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde now with the possession of the ball. Fran Elizalde with a long shot looking for George Maverick. He cannot get the ball. Nico Pérez on the near side. He took the ball, being chased by George Maverick. Nico Pérez on the near side. Nico Pérez, he goes all the way on the near side. Nico Pérez, what a shot. Fantastic. Nico Pérez, he couldn't get the shot he wanted. And who is there on the ball? Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde on the gray. He's coming along. Fran Elizalde. James Harper. Jaime Elizalde. Elizalde that is coming. He has to go past Nico Pérez now. Fran Elizalde with a long shot, trying to find Siri Bassoni. Siri Bassoni with the ball. Siri Bassoni. Siri with the half swing. Siri Bassoni again with the ball. Siri Bassoni, what a play from Siri Bassoni. What a play from Siri Bassoni. She gets hooked in the last minute. And there's an egg shot there from Oli Cadmore to save the ball out of the danger zone in favor of Vikings. Oh, sorry, Scone. Now the ball, Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde turning the ball. They have to move. They have to give him a play. Fran Elizalde leaves the ball there. And the ball comes to the stick of Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez bring the ball this side, looking for James Harper. James Harper waiting for that ball. The ball hits his horse, but Nico Pérez was coming in behind. Leave it to me, buddy. I'll take it off you. And Nico Pérez, here we go. Nico with the ball. The one marking there is George Maverick that tried to hit that open back shot. The ball against the boards. Who's there fighting? Harper and Elizalde. Harper. Harper with the ball. Harper comes inside. Hit it, they say. He hits it, and the ball goes for Oli Cadmore. What a good pass from James Harper. Oli Cadmore has to just finish it off. Let's see if he has time with a little back shot. I think there was a little bit too far, and the ball goes left there for who? Sevi Merlos. Sevi Merlos that called George Maverick, and now the ball goes for George Maverick. The ball is there for Siri Bassoni. Siri Bassoni with the ball. And this will do it with the ball back in the ball for James Harper. James Harper that picked up the loose ball. James Harper is going to turn it. James Harper again. Pretty much exactly from the same place that he was before. Here we go. Harper taking the ball. James Harper coming across the field. Next shot from there. James Harper for Oli Cadmore. And the ball goes wide over the back line. It's a little bit of a long shot. I want to take this opportunity now. I think the guys is the half time. I want to send a couple of messages to say hello, especially for my man and Janina Vecchio and Emilio Vecchio that they're watching the game. Some from Chile, some from Argentina. I wish you all the best and the best for tomorrow, Sunday, Father's Day. Guys, keep in touch. Anyway, also we have some people saying their wishes from all over the world. I want to take this opportunity also to say hello to Ben and Thea watching from Kirindi, the oldest polo club in Australia, and it's also the home place for the Cadmore's family. So Oli Cadmore now playing. They're watching you from your hometown. Then we have Sardar Eisa Khan Legari saying hi. Jan Bradstock Smith cheering for Scone. Maria Nunez giving us all her support. Francisco José Rocafort from Chile. And a few more that are probably going to come back with some messages for us. And I just got one from my brother Agustin saying, hey, boludo, you don't say hello for me and Santi and Matias. There you guys. Guys, enjoy. And let's see what the second half of the second checker will be. The score is 3-1 in favor of Monterroso Viking. Let's see what we can do. The players on the field from Scone. We're waiting for the ones of Monterroso Vikings. Here we go. Everything ready, I think. Is Sebastian Merlo the last one to come? He needs to get all the way to the very end because he's the one in charge of the bringing in, but apparently they have changed since the beginning of this checker. As we saw yesterday on the game of Park Place, also there's a lot of things that they've been changing through the game. They're obviously trying to find the best combination or the best positions for them to help them, I don't know, play better, I guess. So sometimes there's one guy bringing the ball in, and sometimes they change, they try different players, different positions, different techniques, tactics. So let's see what they do. In the first checker, it was Sebi Merlo bringing the ball to Fran Elizalde. That pretty much gave them 3 goals in the score. Now they change from Fran Elizalde to pass the ball to Sebi Merlo. Let's see how they get on with it. Sebi Merlo with the ball. Sebastián. Sebi with the ball. Sebi Merlo hits the ball long. Very long. Looking for George Marek. George Marek with the bouncing ball. He picks up the bouncing ball. Trying to go past Will. Will with a beautiful small short back shot. Perfectly tidy to the stick of Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez. He gets the bump of George Marek. Nico Pérez. Turns. Sebi Merlo. George Marek. George Marek. Trying to get the pass. He doesn't get the pass he wanted. And it's James Harper with the ball. He takes the ball. The bouncing ball. I think there is a whistle. No, they keep on going. James Harper with the ball. And now Harper. Oli Cartmore takes George Marek away from the play. Leaving Harper alone. And Harper from there. Beautiful shot from James Harper from the 60 yards coming across. Almost not far from the boards. James Harper, which what I thought it was going to be an approach. He managed to put the ball through the posts. And it's 3-2 now in favor of Monterroso. From there you see the beautiful shot. You can see in front of him the work of Oli Cadmore getting rid of George Marek. Not to complicate the work of James Harper. And actually worked. And this is it. The score is getting closer. Fran Elizalde with the ball. He has to do something with it. He cannot start tapping it. And now he goes past Oli Cadmore. He missed the ball. He left it for Oli Cadmore. Oli Cadmore with the ball. Oli Cadmore. He left it in behind. So Fran Elizalde recovered the ball. James Harper goes for the near side and the back shot. The umpires blow something. I think they didn't like the angle of the write-off. They're going to go all the way to the 60 yards. Let's see the replay. There, he gets the ball from Oli Cadmore and Harper is coming. A little bit from in front. Yes, there we go. Too much of an angle. A little bit too early. He came across in front of Fran Elizalde. The umpires were quick to blow that foul. And the penalty will be from the 60-yard line in favor of Monterroso Vikings. Here we go, on the ball, Francisco Elizalde. Fran, with the penalty, in his stick. Let's see what he does. Fran, he hits it, he can get the hole he wanted, the ball hit the leg of the horse ends up lame, and they're gonna stop the game for City to get off that horse and check on his pony. I'm sure he will be fine. Normally the horses get hit there and it's just a nerve, and after he walks a little bit he will be fine. But for safety and the welfare, the first thing we do here in these sports is to check on the horses. So if the horse is not happy, they take him off the field and they bring another one. So that's what's happening. They brought her another horse. Nobody wants to risk any injury to any pony. So as soon as we can see there is anything a little bit not right with the ponies, we go and change. The umpires have the right to blow the whistle and stop it. I think that of the book of rules in England and most of the parts in the world, if it's not all of them, the most important rule is the welfare of the ponies. Without horses, we cannot play. So at the same time, I want to take my opportunity, like always I do, to say thank very much to all the organization in behind the scene, which is grooms, lorry drivers, changas, vets, whatever. Endless list of people that works in behind the scene in this polo game. For only 4 players to come on the field on each side, you have probably a team of 60 to 80 people working in behind. So it's a massive industry that is getting bigger and bigger. And that's why we have to take a second and send us our best wishes and congratulations for the work they do to bring the horses in this level and the way they look. Sensational. Here we go with the ball. James Harper. He leaves the ball for Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez with the ball. Nico Pérez, he hits the ball high. Josh Maric going for that ball. Josh Maric is going to play the ball forward. Josh Maric being changed by James Harper. Josh Maric has to come inside. He plays the ball. Harper takes the ball of him, hits the back shot. The first one there is Oli Cadmore is going to turn with it. The first bell has gone, not many time left on the score. They're fighting for that ball. The one that wants to get out with the ball with Fran Elizalde hits the ball far, and that will be a ball for, who's that? Josh Maric. Get hooked. Oli Cadmore with the backhand. The ball for Sevi Merlos. Fran Elizalde hits the ball high, and that's the end of the second checker. The score is 3-2 in favor of Monterosso Vikings, and we will be back with you guys shortly with the beginning of the third checker.
Thinking about polo in Dubai is paradise or oasis, because you come to Dubai, it's a desert, and you see that how Dubai in the last 48 years, how they converted the desert into an oasis. And having Al Habtour Polo Resort or the polo clubs in Dubai here in the middle of the desert, it's like you don't see this anywhere in Dubai.
And I want to welcome you all to have a little bit of a look around at our club, and basically to see the facilities that we have, like the jumping arenas, the sticky ball field here behind me, the stables, polo fields, and all the services that we provide here at the club. We have 10 barns of 52 stables, in total 520 stables. We have all kinds of activities. We have polo tournaments that we all already know. Then we have yaw jumping, dressage. Riding school. We have a polo academy for kids twice a week.
You can plan your polo holidays here. We have a 5-star hotel at the club.
So yeah, we help you with a big variety of activities at the club.
Okay guys, we're back again here for the beginning of the third checker. The players are getting on their horses, about to come back on the field. Guess who is watching us from the other side of the world? I think that is as far as the guy from Ayacucho yesterday. I don't know if it's as far as Christchurch, but Andrea Bianini, what a legend of this game. Andreita, amigo, why you not here sitting with me doing this? Eh? Surely, I'm sure we will have the pleasure of having you here sitting with me, helping me in this commentary with all your knowledge. For those that who don't know him, Andrea Bianini is one of the most successful polo players that this industry had in the past and until today. One of the best, most handsome and happy. What else I can say, Andrea? Come back! Anyway, Andreita, take care, buddy. Here we go with the third checker, the beginning. On the third checker, the score is 3-2 in favor of Monterosso Vikings. Let's see if they're going to change the strategy again. They're going to hit the ball from the 60-yard. In the first checker, Fran Elizalde was the one receiving the pass. In this second checker, it was Fran Elizalde, the one starting from the back, passing the ball to Sevi Merlos. And now, apparently, they're going to stick to that. Fran Elizalde with the ball, bit stationary. The reaction, the explosion of Rani Lizalde to change the dynamic of that game and then run for the pass. Ay, Sebi Merlos, he didn't get the shot he wanted. Leave the ball for Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez, he has to go past Sebi. Sebi on the way. The umpire is complaining. They assume that Sebi was trying to get off the way, which he was, so that's not a foul. He has the right of getting away. So now, Fran Elizalde picks up the loose ball from Sebi Merlos. Fran Elizalde goes past Nico Pérez. Josh Maric doing a good job by Nico Pérez. Nico gets hold in behind. The ball there for Siri Bassoni. On the ball, who will draw it with the backhander. He doesn't get the shot he wanted. The ball goes left there for James Harper. James Harper with the backhand. The ball hits the horse of Josh Maric. Josh Maric goes for the appeal. Instead of going for the ball, he goes for the appeal, end up crashing into James Harper. And let's see what the umpires decide. I think he could have gone for that ball. Let's see what the umpires decide. Let's see the replay. Here, Harper with the backhand. The ball hits the leg of, sorry, it was Sebi Merlos. And Sebi Merlos goes back again into that ball, appealing for the foul. Harper has no play. And the crashing behind, I think, is what the umpires are deciding with the third man. The penalty is in favor of Monterroso Vikings. So, as we saw on the replay, they blown against James Harper. They're coming across the line of Sebi Merlos. And Sebi, at a walk from the 30 yards. He's going to hit that ball. Sebi Merlos, an experienced player. Sebi. And the goal is in favor of Monterroso Vikings. The score 4-2 in favor of them. And here we go. And James Harper waiting for the umpires to throw the ball. They do. And James Harper with the ball. He's going to go looking for Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez go to the right, go to the left. Now he's going to the right. And here we go. The ball goes for him. The first one there on the ball is Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde. He can't get the hold of that ball the way he wanted. James Harper with the ball. The ball hits the boards. George Maric trying to get James Harper. Nico Pérez. They leave it. He left it. Nico Pérez tapping the ball in the air, making it look so easy. Nico Pérez with the ball. He's going to hit from there. He doesn't get the shot he wanted. And now, on the near side, fighting for it, Oli Cutmore. He hits the back shot looking for Nico Pérez. The white player there with the backhander is Fran Elizalde. He gets Sebi Merlos. Sebi Merlos hits the pass back to Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde with the ball. Nico Pérez trying to get Fran. Fran, he's going to leave it or not. He's going to hit it from there looking for Siri Bassoni. Siri Bassoni there. The first one to get there is Will Druitt with a backhand. George Maric turns. Oli Cutmore steals the balls of George. Harper comes and takes George off Oli Cutmore. Fran Elizalde with a hook. Harper comes in behind. Sebi Merlos. Sebi Merlos with the ball. Fran Elizalde takes Oli Cutmore out of him. There we go, the ball for George Maric. George Maric all alone. He has to hit to goal from there. George Maric hit to goal, but a little bit wide. The back one is Will with Siri. Will tried to go for the backhand. He doesn't get the shot he wanted. Nico Pérez backs the ball to Oli Cutmore. Oli Cutmore is getting there. The bump is from George Maric. George Maric, sorry, Sebi Merlo, recover the ball. Now Harper fights for it. Harper. Harper passes to Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez picks up the loose ball. Nico Pérez with the boards. Nico Pérez has to go past George. Nico Pérez cantering with the ball. The horse kicks the ball for him with the knee, almost like passing the ball back to him. Here we go. Nico Pérez with the ball. From there, Nico Pérez, and the ball goes a little bit wide. And I'm still in play. The ball still in play. And is... No, it's gone wide. Finally, the ball go past the back line. and it just went wide over the back line. The umpires decided to blow the whistle for another free change with the score 4-2 in favor of Monte Rosso Vikings. I'm going to say another friends of ours from Texas, from Brunei, from Germany, Des Moines Polo Club, from Myopia, oldest club in the USA. Then from Cornwall, from Lima, Peru, and from Malta. Thank you very much for all of you guys sending your messages from all over the world. We'll try to keep up with the messages as soon as we have time. So, here we go, players changing horses. We're waiting for the players to come back on the field. And this is the halftime of the third checker. The players are changing ponies. And we're going to get on with this third checker. The score 4-2 in favor of Monte Rosso Viking. We have viewers from all over the world keeping up with our transmission through Polo Line TV, the biggest broadcaster of polo in the world. The followers from yesterday, I just been told, for the game of Park Place, 17,000 people watching the game live yesterday. Let's see if today we can beat that record. I think that the game of yesterday, it was very good, but this one, it could be the winner. At the end of the tournament, we're going to choose the game with the most viewers. So guys, keep up and join the team that you're supporting and let us know who you're supporting. At the moment, all the people is texting just to say hi. I want to know who you guys are supporting and who do you expect is going to win. Send them questions. We'll give you answers. Here we go. James Harper with the ball. James Harper trying to go past. The ball going back is Fran Elizalde. Fran Elizalde now in front of James. James has to do something with the ball. He cannot tap it many more times. He hits from there to goal. James Harper. And it's a beautiful goal from James Harper to put the goal. The score 4-3. One more goal for Reds. And they will be back. Here we go. Sebastián Merlo. They have changed again, guys. They changed again. Now is Sebastián Merlo passing the ball to Fran Elizalde. Let's see. Maybe they thought it worked better this way. They change now and Fran Elizalde is going forward. Back to the original positions of Fran playing number 3 and Sebi Merlo playing number 4. With the ball, George Marek. With Nico Pérez in front, George Marek pass the ball to Fran Elizalde. Fran that checks. Harper tried to squeeze the stick. In behind is Fran Elizalde and the ball goes wide. Just a little bit. Here we have James Harper from the back for Scone with the ball. Looking for Nico Pérez or no? He's trying to get Nico somewhere. Here we go. He looks for Oli Cadmour. Oli Cadmour in the back with Sebastián Merlos. Oli Cadmour felt the pressure of Sebastián. Couldn't do much with the ball, but the ball got left for Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez with a beautiful shot. The ball bounced on the leg of a horse. Nico Pérez pick up the ricochet. Nico Pérez with a beautiful leg shot. He hits the ball forward. Who's going there? Who's going to be first? The first one there looks by Nico Pérez. Again, passing the ball to James Harper, but Sebi Merlo is there. Sebastián Merlos with a defending neck shot. George Marek with another defending neck shot. They can get hold of the ball by the looks of it. And the turning is of Oli Cadmore. He was quick on the line. Fran Elizalde, very clever of Fran Elizalde to establish himself on that line. Oli Cadmore, that he got, how do you say, the hunger for the goal, and he decided to turn it. And once he was turning it towards the goal, Fran Elizalde gets on that line and gets a foul, as we saw in our replay, our production. Very well aware of the replays. Thank you very much. Here we go. Fran Elizalde on the possession of the ball from the back. Looking for who? Sebi Merlos. Sebi Merlos with the ball. Now. He tried to hit the ball. He ended up giving the ball for Nico Pérez. Nico Pérez with a beautiful backshot trying to get Oli Cadmore, but Sebi Merlos, he was quick enough to come in behind him and recover that ball, but then he has nobody to pass the ball in front, and he ended up hitting the ball on the hands of James Harper. And quickly and very clever of Sebastián Merlos, he established again himself on the line. Harper hesitate of playing the ball, and as soon as he turned it, Sebi Merlos managed to steal that foul. By the looks of it, he has so much time. He could have turned it this way instead of turning there. Look, there we go. The cross is very, very clear. He should have turned it to the left, and maybe he would have got away with it. But this is what shows you the experience of these players like Sebastián Merlos that have won the Open in Argentina how many times? Queen's Cup, Gold Cup, US Opens, everything. A player with the experience of him, he only needs to counter him behind you and steal a foul. And those days today, with these kind of players, if they steal a 30-yard foul, it's probably not only taking the ball of you, it's also scoring against you. So here we go, let's don't call it before it is, but Sebi Merlos from the 30 yards, at a walk for Monte Rosso Vikings. Sebi Merlos, beautiful ball, nothing Oli Cadmore can do. And there we go, 5-3 is the score in favor of Monte Rosso Vikings, and the ball will be, that's the first bell of this third checker. The ball, it will be with James Harper. James Harper with the ball. For all of you that want to keep entertaining the halftime, we have an interview with Facundo Pérez, which was the best playing player, the MVP from yesterday, the most valuable player from the game of yesterday of Park Place. So we have an interview with him, guys. So if you want to stay in the meantime, in the halftime and watch the interview. I'm going to leave you with that, guys. The score is 5-3 in favor of Monte Rosso Vikings, and I will leave you guys with the interview of Facundo Pérez, that, like always, he has so many interesting things to say that we have to cut the interview a little bit shorter, because if not, we would have been there with him all day, because the knowledge of this guy and the potential of the words that come of his mouth is worth to keep an eye on. See you later. Bueno, welcome back, everybody. I'm here with what we thought he was the best polo player of the game, the MVP, with us, Facundo Pérez. Facundo, well played. It was an interesting game.
See, I think it was a very good game for us. The field was a little bit difficult, and with the rain yesterday, so it was heavy, and we couldn't get the rhythm that we wanted to get. But anyway, we had a good game. We were trying different things, especially these first two games. We were using them to know us, each other, to know the team, to know how we can play. So we are trying different things and practicing, and it's good to have two wins and to have an extra game before Gold Cup starts. It's gonna be good for the team.
A question that we wanted to know, do you guys have a coach? Is Andrew Han your coach, or you have more players?
We have a lot.
No, you have Andrew. So many that anybody could be a coach.
Andrew is a team coach. But luckily we have Hilario and Juano here in the